I am PV Ekhande, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering at Walchand of Technology, Solapur. So today we'll be observing the procedure for finding out strike and dip of the triangular plane. And at the end of the session, the students will be able to find strike and dip of the triangular plane. So let us consider this problem. In this, we have to refer the figure. So figure is given, and from the given figure, we have to find out the strike and dip of the plane. So plane is LMN, for which front view and top view is given. So front view, top view, in which the points are denoted as a LF, MF, and NF. So this is a front view, and this one is top view. Now, for obtaining the strike and dip of the plane, the certain steps are to be followed. Those are to be continued on this figure, so that we'll get the edge view of the plane. And once we get the edge view of the plane, then we'll be able to mention the strike and dip of the plane. Basically, what is meant by the strike? So strike is nothing but the bearing of the true length line which is in the horizontal condition. For that bearing is called as a strike of the plane. Means we should have the horizontal line in the front view. So that is the line parallel to ground, or that line is a horizontal line which appears parallel in this front view. This will indicate true length in the top view, and the bearing of that line is strike of the plane. So that is first part, which is strike of the plane. And second is dip of the plane. In the dip of the plane, there are two things. One is the dip direction, and other is dip angle. So we'll be finding out dip angle as well as dip direction. So step by step, we'll observe the procedure over here. Now in this, first we'll draw the line parallel from NF, because that line will be inside the plane. So this line is inside the plane, and we can obtain the point intersecting to the LM line, and then that point can be projected in the top view to obtain the true length line. Now here, first we'll complete the line parallel from NF position. So from NF we'll draw the parallel line, and this line will have the intersection on this line. So this intersecting point, for instant, will denote as a intersecting point P, and suffix F will mention, because that is a point in the front view. So we'll mention that with the suffix F. Now to obtain P point in the top view, we have to project the point from this PF position in the top view side, and the intersection must be obtained on the respective line, that is ML line. So on LM line, we'll get the intersection in the top view, and that is to be denoted as a PH, and then it is to be connected to the point N in the top view. So first we'll have the projection. So projection of this will take in the top view side. So as told to you, projectors are always to be drawn as a faint line, because that is the construction line, and the intersection of this is on both the lines, that is LM line as well as LN line. But as per the point of intersection knowledge, we should take the point on the respective line, means ML line. So on ML line, we'll have the intersection as a P point with the suffix H. So this is point which is obtained in the top view. Now this line PN is in the true length. So line PN is in the true length, and this line I am showing with the green color. So this line is a true length line, and the strike bearing of this line, which is in the true length for the horizontal condition, is nothing but the strike of the plane. So the strike is to be measured with respect to N point. So here we'll consider the quadrant from north to west. So four directions as which are known to you. The upward direction is north direction, this direction is west direction, and the angle which is subscribed between this vertical line and the true length line, which is called as a strike line. So true length line, or this line is a strike line, is to be measured, and that angle, if we measure from this vertical line, here the angle is 10, 20, 30 and 30. After that, to get the exact position, we must have the extension of this line so that the exact intersection will be obtained. Now this line, when you observe, (10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60) means the angle subtended between the vertical line, which is starting from this center, that is O, is a north line, this is west line. So strike of the plane we can mention as north 60 degrees west. So strike of the plane is north 60 degrees west. Now to get the deep angle and the deep direction, we must draw the line perpendicular to this strike line to get the HV of the plane, because deep angle can be obtained only when the plane is indicating the HV. So we'll draw the plane perpendicular to this. That plane perpendicular to this means that is nothing but the reference line which we are drawing over here. So this reference line is H1 line. So why we are indicating this as a H1? Because this line is intersection of horizontal plane and auxiliary plane number 1. So this area is of horizontal plane, this is of auxiliary plane number 1. That's why we are writing this line as a H1 line. Now on this projector, we have to mark the distance of either PF or NF, because that distance is to be marked on the projector which is starting from N or P. Now that indicates the position of P1 point, or that is nothing but N1 point, because it is on the same line, same projector. Now to obtain the second point, we have to draw the projector from L point. On the projector of L, the distance of L is to be marked. So distance L that is to be marked, LF distance, that will take in compass from this plane, and that will mark from the reference line. So this distance we are observing, which is transferred from this side. So the distance of LF, so this distance we have taken and that we have marked over here. So this point is L1 point. And to obtain the M point, we can have the position of M by taking the projector of this M point. So we'll take the projector of M, and on the projector of M, when you have the line connecting from this L point, the intersection will be obtained as a M point. So this point is M1 point. Now M1 point which is obtained, so that will have the line connecting from L1, this is N1 point and M1, and this indicates HV of the plane. So that indicates HV of the plane. Now the angle of this plane with respect to ground or with respect to HRP is dip angle. So this dip angle will measure either at this location by extending this line, or at the same at the different locations on the line we can measure the angle. Suppose if you want to measure the angle at the L position, we can draw the line passing through this L, and with respect to this we can measure the angle. Now the angle subtended between this horizontal line and the HVO is 59.5 means, now the dip angle of this plane is 59 degrees, or exactly 59.5 degrees. So this angle is 59.5 degrees, which is a dip angle. Now regarding dip direction, it is the direction of the plane towards the ground, or downward inclination of the plane is to be indicated in the top view, which is with respect to strike line. But the angle is to be measured with respect to this line, and that angle we have already measured as a 59.5, and downward inclination, that is to be observed over here. So when we consider the man position over here with respect to this, in this direction the plane is having downward inclination. With respect to this man, when you consider this direction is a direction in which the plane is going in the upward direction. So this is not to be considered, whereas this side is to be considered, this direction is to be considered. So this direction just we are observing in this view, but it is to be mentioned with respect to strike line as a line perpendicular to strike line. So this direction is a dip direction. So this direction is a dip direction. Now this dip direction is in which quadrant? That is in the third quadrant, or that is in the quadrant south to west. So dip direction is southwesterly for this plane. Dip direction is, we can mention as a southwest, or that is southwesterly. So this is the procedure for obtaining the strike and dip of the plane. Thank you.